usage of Hila village names in the north and east, which should be revived. A country's real heritage belongs to the people who produced the culture of that country. It is they who are referred to as the nation. The others merely comprise the population of that country. This is a fact that has been acknowledged even by the United Nations Organization. What forms the foundations to any culture? It is the language. It is around the language that the culture of any country developed. There isn't a culture sans language anywhere in the world. It is in the language of the people who produced the country's culture that trees, creepers, animals, and villages are named. This is a general rule in the world. In these circumstances, the distortion of village names in a country is the destruction of the culture. It is also death blow to the nation that has produced its culture. Death blows had today been dealt on the Sinhala culture and the Sinhala people. In 7 out of the 9 provinces, according to so-called divisions carved out by the British, the village names are in Sinhala, whilst many names in north and east are in Tamil. It is worthwhile investigating whether these names were in Tamil from ancient times or whether they have been changed in recent times. We should ascertain who the original inhabitants of the north and east were in order to find an answer to this question. For this purpose, let us examine historical information such as chronicles, inscriptions, and also archaeological findings such as ruins. The gold plate that was found in Valipura, Vallipuram, states that Isigiri, the Sinhala chief minister of King Vasubha, 55 to 109 AD, visited Nakadiv or Nagadipa in Jaffnak and caused constructions of Vihara there. An inscription belonging to the 10th century found at Dunukava, Dunukai, also states with certainty that it was a Sinhala village. Furthermore, hundreds of inscriptions found in areas of the northern province such as Mahakasbagoda, Mahakachikudi, Erupatana, Mahasiambala Vava, Periyakulam, Pulyamkulam in the Vavuniya district, as well as Puhulmote, Pulmoddei, Siriaya, Tiriai in the Trincomalee district, and also in areas of the eastern province such as Motayakgalla, Motayakkallu, and Galvattithavana confirm well that there were only Sinhala settlements in those areas, even during the pre-Christian era. Even numerous archaeological ruins found in district of Jaffna, Mulleduva, Mulatiu, Vavuniya, Vavuniya, Manunara, Manar, Vatikalo, and Thunmale, Trincomalee, to reveal that these areas were inhabited by the Sinhala people from very ancient times. The Buddhist archaeological ruins found in Mandurugoda, Kandarode, and the metal seals found in the Ethakottuwa, Anaikottai are only two examples. According to the chronicles of Sri Lanka, the Buddha's second visit to Sri Lanka was to Nagadipa. This area, which was inhabited by Sinhala Nagas even before Mihindu era, consists of the present Mulleduva, Vavuniyava, and Trincomalee district. The village Padum Kadaroda, Prachina Kandaraji, the birthplace of Detugamanu's great general Nandimitra, he referred to very much in our chronicles. The chronicles states that gold for the construction of Juan Malisaya was obtained by King Detugemanu 161 to 137 BC from the village of Paliveva, Paliwak. It was 7 yojanas north of Anuradhapura. Henry Parker states that it is the present Vavunikulam. Furthermore, the Kurundava Vihara, considered to have been constructed by Kalunna, Elias Kallatanaga, 109-103 BC, has been identified as Kurundanur, consisting of present Ulleduva. The first Hela commentary, Helatua, too, has been written in this area of Mulleduva. It was the areas of the present Jaffna, Vavuniyava, Mulledu, Padaviya, and Thunmale that King Valagamba, 43-17 BC, toured to mobilize his army to fight against the 5 Tamils. These are only very few facts of those available to show that the present northern and eastern provinces were inhabited by the Sinhala people that we have mentioned above. This confirms well that original inhabitants of these 2 provinces were the Sinhalese. Even so-called Tamil history book called Yalpana Vaippamali, which has conclusively been proved to be a false history, provide us with evidence to show that many Sinhala Buddhists lived in Jaffna. In these circumstances, it is an evident truth that all names of the villages in the 2 provinces of north and east must be Sinhala, just in the same manner as in the other provinces. If so, how were they changed into Tamil, as is found today, as revealed by a Tamil historian, Karthikesu Indrapalan, in his thesis for his doctorate? There were no Tamil settlements in any place in the island, let alone Jaffna. A Tamil-speaking population appeared in the north and the east as a result of some South Indians who fled when a North Indian general, Malik Kafur, invaded their land, and some Malabar people were brought by the Dutch to cultivate tobacco in their plantation. It was they who changed all these village names.